Hi. Evaporation modes are a very critical sphere for metallizing, and the most costly also. So my friends in metallizing often ask me, how can we choose the right evaporation mode for our machine? Since so many people ask this question from me, I thought, why not make a blog so that everybody can get benefited with this? So today we'll be discussing how you should be choosing the right mode for your metallizing machine. First, a little bit about me. I am Anshuman Kunj. I am founder CEO of Supervec Industries LLP. We are a company manufacturing and supplying all kinds of consumables. We supply to around 500 metallizers all across the globe. I am a qualified engineer. I've done my M.Tech and MBA also. I'm also an inventor, a technical blogger, and a published author. Coming back to the subject, for this, I'd like to share my screen. This is the inside of a metallizer. Evaporation board, this is the evaporation board. It is clamped in between two copper clamps and aluminium wire is coming like this, melting and depositing on top of this, forming a pool on top of this evaporation board and then evaporating finally. So how do we select right evaporation board for our metallizer? First important parameter for selection is the resistivity of the board. Resistivity, very simply put, is the measure of resisting power of the specified material to the flow of electric current. If in this evaporation board, current does flow, but with resistance. With that resistance, heat is produced, which melts the metal, normally aluminium in this case. So resistivity is extremely important. Normally, resistivity for a machine would be specified by the machine manufacturer, the metallizer manufacturer. My recommendation will be go with the resistivity that the metallizing manufacturer has specified for the machine. Another important parameter is the wettability of evaporation modes. Wettability, simply put, is a measure of how the molten metal, aluminium in most cases, will behave when in contact with the ceramic board. If wettability is good, the molten aluminium or whatever metal we are trying to deposit will form a uniform pool overhead. A uniform pool means a uniform evaporation and nice coating. Whereas if the wettability is poor, the pool may be in some area and absent in another area. So this place board may get overheated, crack or get damaged, and the coating will also not be proper. So wettability remains an important criteria. For aluminium, no special coating is required, but for certain metals, for coating of certain metals, a separate coating has to be applied on top of evaporation board to give it a little bit better wetting. Another important factor for evaporation board to be considered is its resistance to corrosion. Since most metallizing is done for aluminium and molten aluminium is extremely corrosive metal, and on top of that, if the board hardness is also not, if the wire hardness is also not proper, that wire also comes and hits the evaporation board. So these two factors cause fissures like this to form on top of evaporation board. These fissures may be lengthwise as well as widthwise. So a board with good corrosion resistance will be able to resist this and give a long working life. Another factor that you have to consider while buying evaporation boards is whether to go for two component evaporation boards or three component evaporation boards. Now, two component evaporation boards are constituted of two components. One is boron nitride, another is titanium diboride. Titanium diboride is a conducting element, and boron nitride is the insulating element. So two component board is titanium diboride and boron nitride. Whereas in three component evaporation board, boron nitride is partly substituted with aluminium nitride. So it has aluminium nitride, boron nitride, and titanium diboride. Aluminium nitride being slightly cheaper than boron nitride, the cost of boards comes down slightly. At Supervec, we conducted a detailed study. What we saw was, although using three component boards reduced the cost of boards by about 10% or so, but that also reduces the life of evaporation board by somewhere between 13 to 15%. So not a good trade-off. Here we have tried to compare. Wettability of three component evaporation board is better. Resistance to corrosion of two component evaporation board is better. Life of two component evaporation board is order better. And price of three component evaporation boards is better. So as far as my suggestion goes, I will always say go for two component evaporation board. This offers value for money. Another important parameter while selection is the size of the and the shape of evaporation board. Evaporation boards come in various shapes. Most common is rectangular evaporation board like this, which is used by about 95% of metallizers. But boards do come in other shapes also. Like for example, this is a triangular evaporation board. This is a trapezium shaped evaporation board, also called a TVAP evaporation board. Evaporation boards are also made in the shape of T. And there are evaporation boards that have no cavity on the surface. These are particular variations. At Supervec, we conducted a detailed study once again to find out which works best. What we found was a rectangular evaporation board like this works the best. It can be very properly clamped. It's Geometric design is very robust, and a cavity at the top ensures that the uniform fool forms and proper coating takes place. So I would always suggest rectangular evaporation boat with a cavity on top. Then comes the boat life. Since boat is a very critical sphere for metallizing and the cost, and a costly one also, a better boat life means the economics of scale of production. So boat should have a good life. My suggestion would always be, my expectation for from a boat would always be somewhere around 6 lakh meters of metallizing is a good life for a boat. Of course, it depends on many factors like OD being metallized and all, but the rule of thumb, 6 lakh meters is a good enough life for a boat. Then comes the price. Obviously, for obvious reasons, in these cutthroat competition times, lower the price, the better it is. But price lower should not mean a poor quality also. Then another very important factor often overlooked is easy availability. Since metallizing boat manufacturers are very, very few, so they take a very long time in manufacturing and supplying. Boats are never readily available. So the users, the metallizers keep a huge stock of huge inventory of evaporation boats just to make sure the production doesn't stop. So my suggestion would be always look for a supplier who can give boats quickly so that you don't have to maintain an inventory and block your money. Like at Superbike, we dispatch the boats within 24 hours of receiving the evaporation boats. Look for a supplier like that so that the inventory cost can be reduced. This short lead time is once again very related to the easy availability thing. And that's about all. Thanks a lot for watching this video. In case you have any more queries about evaporation boats or metallizing as such, we run a blog called Vacuum Technology Simplified. You could always view that, or please write to us. We'll be glad to answer your queries. The emails will come at the end of this presentation. Thank you so much for watching.